Alright, welcome back, drywall fans. We're finally at the point where we're going to be able to sand the first coat and put a second coat called the polish coat on. Now what you'll need for this is a mask, which I'm not going to wear right now, otherwise you wouldn't be able to hear me. You need a knife, and you need a pole sander with 100 or basically 100 grit, a rough grit, and a rough sponge. Now what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to go around the wall in some of these areas. We're just going to scrape off some of the chunks, and then we're going to sand the wall, and then we're going to use a little sponge just to kind of get in the corners before we put on our final coat. If we don't prepare the surface nicely, almost like we're almost finishing it, then the next coat won't come out as well. So if we do a nice job on this step, then the next step, putting the mud on and then finally sanding it, will be a lot easier. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is just go around the wall. Get the chunks off. Okay. Just help square things up. Make it a little easier to sand. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our rough sand paper, and since we've made this corner really nice and perfect, we don't really want to go all the way in it, because if we do, we could scratch the inside here. So we're going to just keep about maybe 1 inch away from the corner and sand the flat here and underneath here, and then we'll do the wall here. So generally we go from the top to the bottom. And you usually sand along rather than up and down, because if you go up and down, it'll make it all humpy. But we want to have a nice flat surface to work with. So now you don't need to push too hard. Just let your sandpaper do the work. Otherwise, you'll gouge down to the paper here, and we don't want to do that. A little bit underneath here. Being careful not to go all the way in there to the corner. All right, so we're gonna go up and down here. And again, there's a paper corner in here, so if we press too hard, we're gonna rip the paper, make it all furry, and it won't be good. So just lightly sand that. Always make sure you get your edges well, so that there's no dip between the wall and the drywall mat. All right. Now we'll take our sponge, and where these areas are a little high and low, we're just gonna give them a little sand to kind of square everything off. There we go. So you also want to sand the ceiling here. So again, just keeping a half inch away from the inside of the corner, you go along lightly, and very lightly in the middle here, making sure that we get all the bumps off. When we get to the edge here, we want to have it nice and flat and clean. Alright, so now we've got our surface nice and flat. This surface nice and flat. This surface will be nice and flat once we sand it. Okay, so some of these areas where we've got a flat, a bead, an inside angle, a corner piece, another inside piece, these are usually pretty rough. So you can use your rough pole sander to kind of get the middle part. Generally you need the rough side of a sponge to just gently smooth everything out. Now it's almost like it's finished, but it's still got a few little divots in that stuff. So that's why we're gonna put another coat on. So again, you just, some of these little corner areas you have to get by hand. But if you spend a few minutes fixing them up and making them nice before you put your polishing mud will go on real easy. All right, so now we're ready for some polishing mud. And that'll be our next step. So come on back, 1 second while I go grab the tools and the mud, and we'll start putting it on.